Hey guys, Angel here with the Bullish Bears team. I am making this video today on where to invest in a bear market. Just because I'm making this video today doesn't mean that we are in a bear market or heading into a bear market. It's just important to know what a bear market is and how to protect yourself if and when it comes. The stock market trades in cycles, and what goes up must go down or come down. So that doesn't mean that the stock market is just going to keep going up forever and ever and ever. And if anyone tells you it's going to, then they're probably delusional or lying to you, because it does trade in cycles. And if it just went up and up and up forever, things would become so overbought, so overextended, and the market does need to take a breather. So what is a bear market? Investopedia defines a bear market as a condition in which securities prices fall and widespread pessimism causes the stock market's downward spiral to be self-sustaining. Investors anticipate losses as pessimism and selling increases. Although figures vary, a downturn of 20% or more from a peak in a multiple broad market index such as the Dow Jones or the S&P over a two-month period is considered an entry into a bear market. So if we go ahead and pull up the S&P futures, we can see, pull that up, we can see that over in October, the market did take a downward turn for a few weeks, and people started to panic. And would that make a bear market? Not necessarily, because it takes at least 2 months of the market going down 20% for it to be considered the entry to a bear market. Now, bear markets are shorter than bull markets, so bull markets are going to be around more often because they don't take as, or they take longer than a bear market. But you can see that it went down, it hit this support level, tested it quite a bit, and it couldn't break it, so it headed back up. Now we have this indecision high wave, almost like a shooting star candle forming here today on the S&P, but it did break out of a descending triangle, which is a bearish pattern. So it had this double bottom, which is a bullish, and then it broke out of the bearish pattern, but we're going to see what happens and where it goes, because obviously today is very indecisive. But if you were an investor or a trader in this time frame and you had gone long on some stuff, that would have been a scary thing for you to sign into your brokerage account and learn and see all that red and be like, oh my word, what's going on? What am I going to do? So there are ways for you to protect yourself. And you can take a conservative strategy, which is just cashing out your account. And now you want to do that before the bear market hits or before the worst of the bear market hits. And you can just cash out and just wait it out, sit it out. And there's nothing wrong with that. And you're protecting yourself. And that's what you want to do. You want to protect your brokerage account. And then there is a more defensive strategy where you can find sectors that are steady in a bear market, such as like energy, the healthcare sector, anything to do with like Walmart and even Amazon and Costco, things like that. Some stores and companies that are going to always be bringing in an income. It may not be shooting to the moon every single day of the week, but slow and steady wins the race. And so if you just have this slow, consistent growth, you're still taking in that growth and protecting your account. And then they also pay dividends, and dividends are something that you can also use to protect yourself. And I wrote a blog post on this, and I used the example of Tom Brady and the Patriots in Super Bowl 52, where Tom Brady had one of the best games of all time in Super Bowl history. He threw for 505 yards, 3 touchdowns, and 0 interceptions. And on a normal day, if a quarterback had a day like that, they're pretty much going to win. But the defense was awful, and they couldn't stop the Eagles to save their life. So it didn't matter how great of a game Tom Brady had, his defense was terrible, and they couldn't stop the Eagles, and they lost, unfortunately. And yes, I'm still a little bit bitter about that. Can't do my man Tom Brady wrong like that defense, but thankfully Matt Patricia's gone, and I need to stop talking before I go off on a tangent on Matt Patricia. So it's good to have a good defensive game plan. If you don't have a good defensive strategy, then your account can suffer. And there's also short selling. So when you short sell, you believe a price is going down. You are taking, like if you saw this tanking and you decided, oh, I'm going to take the short position on that. It had that 9 and 20 cross into bearish territory, and I'm just going to short it. So you borrow shares from your broker, and you ride that price down. And then you cover by buying the shares back. Those shares go back to your broker, and you get to keep the profit. There's also options trading. Options trading is in steals and speculation and hedging. So you're hedging your bets. You can actually head over here, and you can trade calls and puts. And puts are the opposite of, that's like the bearish side of options trading. So you could trade these puts over here. You can buy and sell them. You can trade them in spreads. There are a ton of ways to make money in options trading. And the great thing about it is you don't have to put up a ton of capital. One contract controls 100 shares, so you're controlling 100 shares without actually having to pay the price to own 100 shares. So there are so many different ways that you can protect yourself in a bear market. It's just about knowing the strategies and learning the strategies. So you can head over here to read more about my blog post on where to invest in a bear market. And you can also take our courses. Our day trading course teaches you how to short. Our options trading course, again, has all the strategies that you can play to make money in a bear market. And the options can be great with swing trading, especially if you're taking the bearish side, or if your broker doesn't have a ton of shares to short, you have the ability to take those bearish plays with options. And you can head over to our Facebook page. We have our community under the stock market community in our Bullish Bears fan page. And if you like this video, then just like, share, subscribe, comment. And if you subscribe to our YouTube, then you'll just get notifications of everybody that posts content and makes videos, and follow us along on social media. And remember, just because I'm making a video about a bear market doesn't mean we're in a bear market. It just means that we need to be aware that these things are going to happen and be prepared. And I hope you all have a great day, and I'll see you all later.